Hi everyone, my name is Emma Griffiths and I'm a research associate on the Shao Public Health Bioinformatics Lab at the University of British Columbia in Vancouver, Canada. Welcome to Annotating Data Using Ontologies. In this short video, we'll explain why ontologies are the icing in the data cake. We'll discuss how to start annotating your data with ontologies, and we'll highlight the benefits of the ontology-supported data ecosystem. But first, a quick recap about ontologies. From the previous video, we know that ontologies are collections of controlled vocabulary that are arranged in a hierarchy. Every term is clearly defined and disambiguated through the use of unique identifiers. Terms can also be linked to alternative spellings, synonyms, and different languages. And importantly, there are logical relationships between the terms that help to link information together in different ways. So what do we mean when we say annotate your data? Well, if you were a manuscript editor, you would mark up or label a manuscript text in a way that provided additional information or ideas. Scientists can do the same sort of thing by labeling their data with ontology terms and IDs in spreadsheets and databases. So why would we describe annotating your data as the icing in or on the data cake? Well, this is because annotating or decorating data with standardized terms and unique identifiers better enables harmonization of data between cohorts, studies, and across different uses of the data. That kind of standardization also enables better interoperability of the information across applications and systems. It prepares data for more complex analyses like machine learning, and it also prepares the data for future uses and applications that we might not have even thought of yet. Furthermore, as with icing layers inside the cake, ontologies also contribute structure, logic, and even additional layers of information, which serve to enrich the data and build the data cake. We'll learn how ontologies can enhance data analysis in our next video. The CINECA project aims to enable the harmonization of metadata across 10 different cohorts from around the world. One cohort in particular is called CHILD, or the Canadian Healthy Infant Longitudinal Development Study, which examines the environmental, genetic, and socioeconomic factors that lead to the development of asthma and allergy in children. The CHILD study is actively annotating a number of their datasets with ontology terms. In this example, we see a list of medications that have been taken by children in the cohort, which were recorded by their mothers when the children were about 1 year of age. In the upper table, we see a list that contains a mixture of drug brand names, as well as drug names with different spellings and synonyms. In the lower table, extra columns have been added containing standardized ontology terms and their associated identifiers for the active ingredients of the medications. This makes the information more comparable, more queryable, and trends can more easily be identified. For example, using the annotated data, you can now compare outcomes of children who have taken an unknown antibiotic to the outcomes of children that took gentamicin and neomycin, which are both types of antibiotics. The link between specific antibiotics and the general term antibiotic can be made using the ontology hierarchy. In general, extra columns containing ontology label and ID information can be added in spreadsheets or as extra tables in databases. Data collection instruments can be designed with selection menus containing relevant ontology terms. In the example shown here, a spreadsheet-based data collection instrument for antimicrobial resistance testing data enables users to select standardized terms from a menu which are linked to ontology IDs that are populated in an accompanying worksheet. So how do we get started annotating our data with ontology terms? Well, luckily there are different tools available to help us do this, and a great service that we highly recommend is the EBI Ontology Lookup service. It enables you to enter the terms of interest into a search bar, and the OLS will search over 240 ontologies and controlled vocabularies to find the best matches. You can see in this example that when the term antibiotic is searched, the OLS identifies not only the ontology terms, but also their corresponding IDs, as well as their definitions. Now, while the OLS requires you to search terms individually, there are also tools which enable the automation of batch searches. LexMapper, a tool developed in our lab, is a rule-based ontology-driven tool for transforming free text describing sample source information into standardized ontology terms. It can also map ontology terms to a third-party classification scheme. The third-party scheme is up to you. You tell us how you want your terms organized, and we'll encode that in LexMapper through an ontology intermediate. LexMapper has a locally installable command line version, which is publicly available, so you can standardize your data privately on your local machine. But it's also available as an online service. As you can see in this video, you simply upload a CSV file containing your sample IDs and sample descriptions. When you submit your data, you'll be given a link where you can retrieve your results. Results are downloadable and delivered in tabular form and contain your original entry, ontologized terms, and higher level classifications. And you can process thousands of entries in minutes. The service is offered through one of our servers at the BC Center for Disease Control. Similarly, the EBI also offers a very fine service for mapping free text to ontologies called Zuma. All you have to do is enter the text into the search box and Zuma will map your terms in seconds and return results in tabular form. The results include your original text, your mapped ontology terms, the source of the terms, and even a mapping confidence value. So there are also a number of tools that enable you to build data collection instruments, like questionnaires or surveys and spreadsheets that offer ontology terms to users. One example is called REDCap, which is a secure web application for building and managing online surveys and databases. While REDCap can be used to collect virtually any type of data, it's specifically geared to support online or offline data capture for research studies and operations. REDCap databases and surveys can be used by researchers across multiple sites and institutions. Another tool that enables users to build templates to transform information into ontologies and validate data entries is called Webulus, which is developed by EBI. For more advanced users, another tool our team has built is called GEEM, which is a platform for building ontology-based specifications. You can kind of think of it as an Amazon for ontologies, because it enables a user to surf particular ontologies and to choose the standardized fields and terms that they want using a shopping cart functionality. These collections of fields and terms can be saved and stored either privately or publicly, and you can then compare the specifications to see what's common between them, for example, between different cohorts. Or you can save the specifications and software developers on your team can use it to create forms or whatever ontology-containing applications or data collection instruments your organization needs. So how do all of the tools that we've described work together to create an ontology-supported data ecosystem? Well, ontologies like Foodon, the food ontology, Genepio, the genomic epidemiology ontology, and KEBI, the chemical entities of biological interest ontology, just to name a few, provide standardized terms and identifiers. Standardization tools like LexMapper and Zuma and GEEM enable users to apply ontologies and annotate their data. And data management tools like Webulus and REDCap, as well as spreadsheets and databases, enable users to store and manage their annotated data. And it's this ontology-supported ecosystem that the CINECA project will leverage to better enable metadata harmonization across cohorts to accelerate disease research and improve human health. Thank you for watching our video about annotating data with ontologies. In our next video, we'll discuss ways to make use of ontology annotated data. For more information, please check out the links mentioned in the video, as well as our websites genepio.org and foodon.org. To contact us, please send us a message at info@genepio.org. See you next time.